How to invent something new. Do you ever wonder how do the successful people invent things? How do they learn about things quickly? What makes them stand apart? Is it their IQ level or is it some kind of smart strategy they use? So hi guys, this is Prateek and you are watching Eclectic. It is never about the IQ level. So let us just strike that out. Today, you and me are going to see how great inventors and successful people do things differently. Let us start with the reading and research. Do not directly start reading a book or searching about the topic on the internet. Before starting to read about anything or starting to research on anything, form a basic set of questions in your mind or on paper. Let us say you want to read about the artificial intelligence. First, form a basic set of questions like what is artificial intelligence, when it started, what artificial intelligence do, and what are the applications of artificial intelligence, etc. After forming these questions, when you will read about the artificial intelligence, one by one all your doubts will be cleared and you will be able to remember them more efficiently. While reading, always write down notes on paper. Throughout our history, all creative people have shaped their ideas on paper. Whatever you start, always start from the beginning, from the roots of that subject. Always try to know the history of that subject or technology. It would help you to understand how that idea or invention arrived in the first place. For example, if you read the history of artificial intelligence on Wikipedia or in books, you would find out that the idea of artificial intelligence first arrived in the science fiction books like Mary Shelley's Frankenstein, a machine that can think and learn. So see, you get to know how it all started in the first place. The next thing is visualizing. Do you know how filmmakers and actors read the stories? They visualize all the events and scenes described in the story. Even a legendary inventor like Nikole Tesla, a man who is the reason we get electricity at our homes, a man who introduced us to alternating current by inventing an induction motor. He read hundreds of books while visualizing all the theories, and you know what? Before inventing that motor, he was literally able to visualize how that motor would work. Even most of the theories of Albert Einstein are based on imagination and visualization. He first visualized it, then he tried to prove it based on science. Relating your old knowledge with the new one. If you read new things about any topic or any technology, relate your old knowledge of the subject with the new one. Pay attention to how that thing or technology has changed over the time. It gives you a sense of creativity. Let's put it into our example of artificial intelligence. If you have already read something about the artificial intelligence in the past, and now you are reading new things about it, focus on how people have changed that technology over time, how they have modified it. It will make you more creative and you will be able to bring new things into the world. Now your job is to bring in lots and lots of ifs, could-bes and would-bes. What if I do this? What would be the outcome? What modification or advancement could be there? Remember these words of Leonardo Da Vinci. It is not enough to see what is there. You need to think what could be there in times to come. In any field, it is true. If you take the example of technology sector, learning how to modify current things or technology can make you a good innovator. Now all this reading and researching can make you tired. Sometimes you feel demotivated, especially if you are not getting desired outcome. It is common for everyone. Even all the successful and most creative people struggle with this problem. Therefore, here is a unique strategy to set a goal or a target for yourself. When you set a target or a goal, divide it into time span and milestones. For example, you can set a target for yourself that in 2 years, I am going to achieve this much and that would be my first milestone. I think we should make it easy with the example of Hollywood actor Arnold. His ultimate goal was to become rich and famous. When he was young, he set a goal for himself. Arnold's first goal was to become the greatest bodybuilder in the world, which meant becoming Mr. Olympia. When he accomplished that goal, he set out to become a Hollywood actor. After his acting career, he became the governor of California. So see, ultimate goal always remained the same. He just divided them in sub-goals. If you divide your life's ultimate goal in sub-goals, then when you achieve these sub-goals one by one, you feel rewarded and happy, and that is the thing which keeps anyone going, and it will keep you going towards your ultimate goal. Even science approves it. When you get a reward or whenever people praise you, your brain releases dopamine, which makes you happy. Even social media sites like Facebook and Instagram work on this principle. Whenever you upload a photo or a video, you always tend to check your profile repeatedly for seeing how many likes you are getting, how many comments you are getting. Those likes make you feel rewarded and your brain makes you happy by releasing dopamine. So celebrate when you achieve your sub goals one by one. But remember, all your sub goals should serve your ultimate purpose, because destination can remain the same, but paths can be different. Now that the reading, researching and defining your target is over, now comes the very important step, which is surrounding yourself with like-minded people. Elon Musk, a billionaire entrepreneur and the founder of PayPal, Tesla Motors and SpaceX, serves as the best example for this. Before Elon Musk founded PayPal, an online payment service, he worked as an intern in a bank. He wanted to surround himself with the bankers and get to know the banking system. After PayPal, when he wanted to do something in the space industry, he read many books about rockets and lived in Los Angeles. He moved to Los Angeles because it is the major manufacturing hub of the aerospace industry. The US Air Force, NASA, and Boeing have performed much of their cutting-edge experimentation and manufacturing at Los Angeles. Elon Musk got himself surrounded by scientists, and now SpaceX is the successful company, which is trying to take humans to Mars. After all this comes the application, the real use case of whatever you have invented, made, or built. Your service or your product is useless if people don't use it. Making your product accessible to people is important, and that is tricky. Sometimes people do not realize that they need something or some technology to make their life easier. So you should be able to create that need for your product in people. When Apple invented its first iPhone, Steve Jobs gave an explanation, a good presentation to people that how this device is going to make their life easier. Here is a 30-second clip of how he explained it.
This is a day I've been looking forward to for 2.5 years. Every once in a while, a revolutionary product comes along that changes everything. Today, we're introducing 3 revolutionary products of this class. The first one is a widescreen iPod with touch controls. The second is a revolutionary mobile phone. And the third is a breakthrough internet communications device. So, 3 things: a widescreen iPod with touch controls, a revolutionary mobile phone, and a breakthrough internet communications device. An iPod, a phone, and an internet communicator. An iPod, a phone. Are you getting it? These are not 3 separate devices. This is one device. And we are calling it iPhone. Today, Apple is going to reinvent the phone.
Remember this, if you cannot explain your concept or product in simple manner, then you don't understand it well enough. Start explaining your concept to your friends, your girlfriend or parents and see how they respond. Explain your concept by giving day-to-day life examples. Simplify your explanation as much as possible. Imagine that you are explaining your concept to a 4th grade student. If he can understand it, then anyone can. At the end, here is a grand advice. People will always tell you that if you want to invent something or want to start a new business, you just need to find out a problem and then a solution for that problem. But that is not true. It is not that simple. You cannot come up with an idea unless you have read lots of books or articles about that particular field in which you want to invent something. You can only rectify or identify a problem if you have a particular level of knowledge about that field or if you have a good work experience in that field. This rule is same for every field and every invention. Even the great inventor Nikola Tesla worked many years under Edison to understand how the electricity works, and then he invented an induction motor, which generates alternating current. Do not ever think that idea will just suddenly pop up in your brain. You need a good amount of knowledge for that. Now, I want your help. If you feel my video is good, spread this video to people as much as possible. Share it with your friends and on your social media handles. It would be really helpful for me. Read lots and lots of books and work till you find what you are interested in. Practice your skill till you feel it is natural. Thank you all very much. See you soon.